What's up, guys? Charles here. The best CPUs by AMD represent excellent value for their money, offering high core counts and blistering clock speeds at reasonable prices. The most recent Ryzen 7000 range includes processors that can go toe-to-toe with the best from rival Intel. The question is, which Ryzen CPU should you pick up? The Ryzen family is broken down into four distinct branches, targeting the market's entry-level, mainstream, performance, and high-end enthusiast sectors, otherwise known as Ryzen 3, Ryzen 5, Ryzen 7, and Ryzen 9. They're all great chips in their ways, but some certainly offer more value than others. And for many, the most powerful chips will be completely overkill. Then there are also the top CPUs for gaming that belong to AMD's 3DV cache lineup. We'll explore all options and help you pick the chip that best fits your needs. Number 1. Ryzen 5 7600, the best value Zen 4 processor. It's a reasonable processor that can suit both budget and mid-range builds. The AMD Ryzen 5 7600 is a well-rounded CPU that comes with 6 cores and 12 threads. For a chip that costs just over $229, it also offers an impressive clock speed of 5.2 GHz, making it an all-around decent deal. Sure, it's a lot pricier than its last-gen counterpart, but the generational upgrades that it brings make it an overall better pick if you're looking to build a PC that won't require upgrades for a few years. Performance-wise, the Ryzen 5 7600 is extremely close to the Ryzen 5 7600X, although its clock speed is lower both at the base and at the maximum boost level. Aside from that, the specs are exactly the same, down to the 38 MB of combined cache. However, buying the 7600 is helpful for extra savings because it comes with a bundled CPU cooler, something that the 7600X does not provide. Outside of the cost of the processor itself, you have to be ready to pay a premium for an AM5 motherboard, as the 7600, alongside its other Ryzen 7000 siblings, is not backward compatible with AMD's old AM4 platform. It also requires DDR5 RAM, so any old DDR4 memory won't work. However, the extra money gets you solid performance in gaming and productivity, and most of all, an easy upgrade path until, at the very least, 2025. Number 2. Ryzen 7 7800X3D, the best Ryzen CPU for gaming. It's the fastest gaming CPU by a mile. Gamers who don't need a CPU for productivity and want superb gaming performance. When the Ryzen 7 5800X3D first came out, we were impressed by its boundless gaming potential, which made the Ryzen 7 7800X3D a highly anticipated follow-up. Walking in the footsteps of its predecessor, this CPU proceeds to tick all the boxes a gamer could ask for. It's reasonably priced, it's lightning fast, and it can breeze through even the most demanding games. Much like its older sibling, the 7800X3D supports 8 cores and 16 threads. However, it boosts the clock speeds up to 5 GHz and the combined cache size to 104 MB. Compared to the Ryzen 7 7700X, the clock speeds are lower, but the extra cache more than makes up for it in gaming scenarios. The 7800X3D costs around $400, which makes it somewhat expensive but still reasonable. Number 3. Ryzen 5 5500, the best Ryzen CPU under $100. The Ryzen 5 5500 is the cheapest Zen 3 desktop CPU and has good mid-range performance. For gamers and hobbyists who want the best bang for their buck, the Ryzen 5 5500 is the cheapest CPU in the last-gen Ryzen 5000 lineup, making it ideal for budget-oriented builds. Don't underestimate it based on its sub-$100 price tag, though. It's a decent CPU that can be used for all kinds of gaming as well as productivity. And although you shouldn't expect it to fit neatly into a monster PC build, it'll serve you well and at a low cost. This CPU sports 6 cores and 12 threads, utilizing the Zen 3 architecture. On the surface, this is identical to the more expensive 5600X as well as the Ryzen 5 5600. But the 5500 is actually quite different from its neighbors. The 5500 is based on the same silicon that Ryzen APUs use, but with the integrated graphics disabled. This means the 5500 only has 16 MB of L3 cache, as opposed to the 32 MB of the 5600X and 5600. Despite this lack of cache, the 5500 performs well enough to be worth it. The 5500 can easily do 120+ frames per second in esports games, and has similar multi-threaded performance to the 5600 and 5600X. If you're looking for the best bang for your buck, it's just not worth it to pay more for the 5600X or the 5600. Number 4, Ryzen 97950. The best high-end Ryzen CPU. It's AMD's best processor right now, users with huge budgets who want the best of the best. If you're aiming for the stars, this CPU should be your goal. The Ryzen 97950X sits atop AMD's non-3D lineup, and rightfully so. It's a powerful processor with a lot of potential both for productivity and for gaming. And although it isn't cheap, it is the chip you want to go for in a high-end PC build. However, there are some caveats. The 7950X comes with 16 cores and 32 threads. It has an eye-watering clock speed that can be boosted up to 5.7 GHz and a mighty combined cache, 80 MB. It's also quite power-hungry, what with the 170W TDP, so be ready to invest in a top-notch power supply and an AIO cooler. Both of those things are the staples of a high-end build, though, so you're probably ready for it. While this CPU retails for around $599, having already received significant price cuts from its initial list price of $700, it's still not cheap. It'll also force you to buy an AM5 motherboard, which is still mildly pricey, and DDR5 RAM. However, those upgrades are great for future-proofing, and once AMD comes out with next-gen processors, you'll be ready for an easy upgrade. If you're looking for a productivity beast, this CPU is your best bet in the AMD lineup. The Ryzen 97950X3D is better for gaming purposes, but it also provides worse value and productivity performance. So it all comes down to what you need in your PC. Number 5, Ryzen 75700X, the best value Zen 3 CPU for productivity. The Ryzen 75700X provides both a good gaming experience and high performance in productivity tasks. For those users who want to game and work on the same PC, if you want more performance in the productivity department while maintaining great frame rates in games, but aren't quite ready to switch to the new Zen 4 processors, you'll want the Ryzen 75700X. The 7 series part comes with 8 cores and 16 threads, while featuring the same IPC and memory improvements as the Ryzen 55500 and the 5600G, and boost higher with a max boost clock of 4.6 GHz. The 5700X costs around $200 these days. The 5700X not only has a much more reasonable price tag, but also has about the same performance in games and isn't far behind in multi-threaded applications and other software. Enabling Precision Boost Overdrive on the 5700X basically turns it into a 5800X with no discernible differences, making the more expensive 5800X almost pointless. If you need integrated graphics, the Ryzen 75700G is basically the APU version of the 5700X. But just as the 5600 has less L3 cache than the 5600 and 5600X, the 5700G also has less cache than the 5700X, 16 MB versus 32. The 5700G currently goes for around $200. So you're not saving any money other than not having to shell out extra cash on a discrete graphics card. Number 6, Ryzen 5 5600G. The best value Ryzen APU, the Ryzen 5 5600G, is the cheapest Zen 3 desktop APU, providing both good CPU performance and decent integrated graphics. For those gamers who can't afford a discrete GPU at the moment, and hobbyists who want to build a compact PC without discrete graphics, the Ryzen 5 5600G is basically the Ryzen 5 5500, But it has the 6 Zen 2 cores and 12 threads, though the same 16 MB Level 3 cache. It also has slightly higher clock speeds and working integrated graphics. The 5600G can be found for around $130, and although this price isn't nearly as affordable as the venerable Ryzen 3 3200G, which often retails for well below $70, the 5600G is far more capable thanks to faster and more numerous CPU and GPU cores. If you want to build a fast but budget-friendly PC without discrete graphics, the 5600G is the best Ryzen APU you can choose. Older and slower Ryzen APUs are either out of stock or are more expensive, which makes the 5600G really the only choice for this segment. The 5600G is also decent for people who don't want or can't really afford a good discrete GPU now, but plan on getting one later. Even though the 5600G is pretty mid-range, you could pair it with a fairly high-end GPU like the 3070T as long as you're just aiming for 60 to 120 FPS. The 16 MB Level 3 cache is particularly limiting for playing newer and more demanding games, but it's hard to not recommend a $130 APU with good gaming performance, good multi-threaded performance, and decent integrated graphics. Number 7, Ryzen 7 5800X 3D. The fastest Zen 3 CPU for gaming. It's the fastest gaming CPU from the Zen 3 generation. Gamers who want the highest performance possible on an AMD platform but want to stick to a tighter budget. Thanks to AMD's 3D V-Cache technology, the 5800X 3D has a whopping 96 MB of L3 cache, way higher than anything we've ever seen on a consumer CPU back when it was released. However, it only has 8 cores, the same 8 cores you'll find in the 5700X. This means that while the 5800X 3D can go head-to-head with the Core i5-13600K and the Ryzen 7 7700X in games, it gets left in the dust in anything more multi-threaded. The 5800X 3D usually retails for around $330. While that's affordable compared to the price it launched at, it still finds itself in an awkward position because there are CPUs that offer better performance at a similar price point. For instance, you'd be better off picking up the Core i7-13700K, which is on par with the 5800X 3D in gaming, but miles better in productivity. It all comes down to what you need the most. The 5800X 3D is the best choice for gamers who want the best or nearly the best gaming performance guaranteed while also saving some money. The Ryzen 7 7800X 3D is a faster and better option, but it'll cost you an extra $80. On the other hand, the 5800X 3D remains a fan favorite because it's locked to the AM4 platform, and this is both a blessing and a curse. It means you'll get cheaper motherboards and affordable DDR4 RAM to pair it with. But it also means you won't be able to upgrade it without swapping the motherboard, and that often means several other upgrades will be required too. That's it for today's video. Do consider subscribing for all the latest content on gaming, and as always, I'll see you in the next one. Peace out.